How's school today?
Good.
Good. I'll be right back.
Dad?
Sweetheart, just give me a second. I gotta take care of a couple of things. Everything's fine. I think it looks nicer like this. Don't you?
Ross, what's happening? Pick the kids downstairs right now. Right now. What the hell are you doing?
Amy, you're gonna have to trust me. This is for your own protection.
Get out of the house right now. Hey, are you listening to me? You are scaring the kids. If you don't leave immediately, I'm calling the police, and I warn you, you will never see your kids again.
Amy, I am not crazy. These mirrors are dangerous. At first, I thought it was just the ones in the store, but after Angela was killed, I realized I can get at you anywhere. I promise I will leave the house. Just let me cover these damn mirrors.
What's wrong with you? I know what you've been going through hasn't been easy. But guess what? It hasn't been easy for us either. Angela was a part of our lives too. You know that? It's not fair what you're doing to us, Ben. Michael, he's acting so strange now. He always wants to be alone. He won't talk to me. He's having nightmares. Ben, your behavior is rubbing off on him. He is 6 years old. I have to protect him.
I'm gonna show you something.
Me.
You don't want to believe me? Fine, I'll show you.
What are you doing?
I'll show you!
Are you crazy? Have you gone completely mad?
Just wait, you'll see.
See what?
You'll see.
Say what, Ben? What am I supposed to see?
Amy, I swear to you, at the Mayflower. I am not lying.
Ben, let's go back inside, okay? Gone away. Listen to me, baby. I want to help you.
Till it gets, I'm sorry.
Ben!
Oh!
Larry, it's me. I need your help again. I'm trying to locate the patient-employee manifest for St. Matthew's Hospital.
Where is it?
Where was it? They closed it down, but it was in New York. It's where the Mayflower used to be.
The Mayflower?
Yeah.
The department store?
Do you have any idea where they would store records for a hospital that's been closed for over 50 years?
No, I don't, but I can send someone to City Hall to check it out. If it's a public hospital, there'll be a record of it. Tell me exactly what you need.
Same thing. I'm looking for a patient or an employee with the name Essaker.
All right, I'm on it. Give me a couple hours. And Ben, keep your head down.
Get it?
Yeah, I think so. It's, Anna Essaker. I didn't really know what she wanted, so I got all the medical files.
This is perfect, Larry. This is perfect.
What happened? Did you get in an accident?
Anna Essaker's files. Did you have to go to City Hall for it?
No, I didn't have to go anywhere. All the files in that place were in storage with the cold case items.
Why, because of the fire?
No, it's before the fire. It's a totally different case. Anna was a patient at St. Matthew's. She's in the psych ward run by Dr. Kane. I get this, though. She was only 12 years old when she died.
What?
When the nurses were on their rounds, first thing in the morning, October 6, 1952, they discovered that all the patients had left their rooms during the night, and they'd all gathered in the main hall. Then, they were all dead, including the girl. Apparently, they killed each other. I mean, it was a slaughterhouse. That's when they closed the place down, and knows what really happened.
What about the doctor? Kane.
Well, they arrested him. They found him dead for a state of hearing. He slashed his wrist with a piece of the cell mirror.
Thanks for your help.
Good luck.
Pennsylvania, August 1951. They don't match. And Esker was discharged from St. Matthew's Hospital October 4th. 2 days before.
You almost done, sweetie?
Okay.
Why is Daddy acting so scared? It's not normal.
He's way older than me. And I'm not acting scared, but he is. doesn't make any sense.
Michael?
What are you doing?
Nothing.
Okay, well, you gotta get going, all right?
Okay.
Okay.
Amy.
Oh, Ben.
Amy, what's wrong?
You have to come to the house right now. I'm so scared.
Amy, what's wrong?
I'm so scared.
Amy, just tell me what happened.
There's something in the house. Something in the house.
I'm on my way.
God damn it.
You coming back home?
Please, sweetheart. Come here.
I love you, Daddy.
I love you too, sweetheart. I gotta go.
I'm afraid to stay here.
There's gonna be windows and mirrors wherever you go. Anything that causes a reflection right now is dangerous. At least inside the house, we've covered everything. It's the safest place to be. Amy, I'm so sorry.
No, it's not your fault. I should have believed you. Do whatever it takes to end this. You hear me?
I will.
Yes, sir?
Excuse me. Is this Jessica from?
What is it, Jim?
I don't know, Ma. But what can I do for you, sir?
I'm looking for Anna Essaker.
There's a man looking for, you said Anna?
Yes, Anna Essaker.
An Anna Essaker, Ma.
Look, I'm sorry to bother you. I must have the wrong place.
What is it you want with Anna Essaker?
I'm doing a research paper on schizophrenia. I became familiar with Anna Essaker's case. I just wanted to ask her some questions.
Go tell Grandpa as a man here is asking about his sister. Okay.
Thank you.
Grandpa.
You know, up to this day, visions of Anna's fits still haunt me at night. Well, I helped my father fix up this part of the basement, especially for her. Her fits were too violent. My mother couldn't take her screams anymore. Well, we had every priest, doctor, healer coming in from all over the county. No one could help her. Dr. Kane from New York answered my parents' cries for help. He rejected the idea of demonic possession, said he didn't believe in it. He was convinced Anna suffers from a rare form of personality disorder. Mirrors could help her. He wanted Anna under his care, St. Matthews. My parents were very poor. He agreed to cover all the costs of the hospital.
Where'd she go after the hospital?
Don't you know? She died there with all of Kane's other patients.
Mr. Essaker, I read the file. Anna left the hospital 2 days before the massacre. Dr. Kane altered the documents so she could disappear.
Yeah. Where did you get that document?
I need you to tell me where she went after St. Matthews.
Well, she came back and stayed with us for a while.
What do you mean, for a while? What happened? Why did she leave?
I don't want to talk about that.
Why did she leave?
Because strange things started to happen in the house.
With Anna?
No, not with Anna anymore. No, she was totally cured.
Strange things started to happen with the mirrors, didn't they? Mr. Essaker, I need to know where Anna is now. It's a matter of life and death. Do not make me threaten you.
We sent her somewhere where mirrors are forbidden. Where the mirrors couldn't find her.
Where?
St. Augustine's Monastery, on the road to Reedfield.
How can I help you?
I'm sorry to disturb you, sister, but I've come to speak with a member of your community, Anna Essaker.
Is she expecting you?
No, not really.
If you are not listed, I cannot help you, sir.
Can you at least tell her that I've come from New York to speak with her? I work with Dr. Kane from St. Matthew's Hospital. It's very important, please.
St. Matthew's closed down in 1952. Who are you?
My name is Benjamin Carson. I work as a night watchman on 6th Avenue in New York City, in the building that used to be St. Matthew's Hospital.
What is it you want, Mr. Carson?
My family's in danger, and what's threatening them is asking for you. I came all this way to ask you why the mirrors that were left over from St. Matthew's Hospital are so desperate to find you. Please, Miss Essaker, if you don't help me, I'm going to lose the most important thing to me in this world, and that's my family.
Sit down, Mr. Carson. The mirrors are merely windows on our world. It is not the wish of the mirrors to find me, but of what is imprisoned inside them.
What is imprisoned inside them?
At the time that I was at St. Matthew's, Dr. Kane's therapy for personality disorders consisted of locking the patient up in a mirrored room for several days on end, forcing them to confront their own image. Dr. Kane was wrong about his theory. There is no cure for schizophrenia, Mr. Carson. It was something else. And whatever it was, it left me and entered the mirrors. Since that day, it has been collecting the souls of the people it kills. I'm sorry. But if I agree to go with you and return back to that place, I will make it possible for the demon to cross the threshold back into the real world.
Do you understand what that means for my family? You can't do this. You need to come back with me.
I'm going to pray for you and your family. That's all I can do right now, Mr. Carson. I'm sorry. God bless you.
Gary Lewis, Terrence Barry, and many other men have died trying to find you. And because they failed, their families died too. 2 days ago, my sister was murdered. My family will be next if you don't help me. Please. Please. Wait. This is my family. It's my wife, Amy, and my daughter, Daisy, and my son, Michael. They're beautiful. They're innocent. They've never hurt anybody. Please, take the photo. Just take the photo. Look at them.
I'm sorry.
Who the hell do you think you are? They're just kids!
Hello?
Amy.
Ben, where are you?
At the monastery.
Did you find her?
Yes.
Yeah? Did you talk to...
Amy?
Michael?
Ben, hold on. Michael's gone.
What do you mean?
I don't know. I fell asleep with the kids on the bed and now I don't know where he is.
Michael?
Amy, what's going on? Is everything all right?
Oh, fuck.
Amy, what's going on? Have you got Michael?
Oh my God. Ben, there's water everywhere. Oh my God.
You've got to be careful of the water. It creates reflections.
Someone's in the house. Someone scraped off mirrors.
Amy, where is Michael?
I don't know where he is. I don't see him anywhere.
Amy, listen to me. You've got to stay away from the water. Get the kids and stay away from the water.
Michael?
Hey.
dying tonight. You were coming with me.
Daisy, come here. I would never hurt you, know that. Here, hold this. Hold it tight. Okay. Here, get down, sweetie. Let me see. Let me see, sweetie. It's gonna be okay, all right? I know it hurts. Stay right there. All right, give me your hand. I need you to hold it really tight, okay? Just flat and tight, just like that, okay? Now, I need you to listen to me, okay, baby? You have to be very brave. Okay. I need you to stay here no matter what happens. No matter what you hear, do not move from this closet until I come back. You understand me, right? Okay. Okay. Do not move. I love you. Don't move. Where are you?
Don't be scared, Mommy. He just wants to play with us.
Michael, I want you to drop that knife right now. Do you hear me? You know very well you're not allowed to play with knives, don't you? Come on. That's a good boy. Give me the knife, Michael. Michael! 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 Ah! Michael, why are you hiding from me, sweetheart?
It's waiting for me downstairs. Bring me inside. From now on, I have to keep my eyes closed.
You're in the room.
Strap me. I spent the darkest days of my life in this room.
Are you sure there's no other way?
It's for your family, Mr. Carson. For your family.
Michael? Michael, look at me!
Ugh.